Let's say you need to use media files in your mobile application, or that you just want to store another type of file in a scalable and robust way. If you have this use case, join me in this episode of Decoded Quick Hits, where we'll go through the Amazon S3 connector and use it in a mobile application in OutSystems. Okay, so two things we need before we get started: to create an AWS account and to download and install the Forge component for the AWS S3 product. So let's go through the AWS account part. I already have a free account. It's easy, you just sign up for a free account, you'll find it. And then we want to go to the identity and access management, go to users. And as you can see, I already have some of them. We will be using this one, but you probably will need to create a new one. Add users, choose a name, and choose the programmatic access, as we will need the access key and the secret access key. Next, you have to go through the permissions. And for this test, is just full access to S3, to the service. Be careful with a real world application, as you might want to be more strict on this type of policies. And later, to finish creating a new user, you will have the secret and access key given to you. This is only one time thing, so make sure to store those credentials in a safe place, because if you forget them, you'll have to create new ones. And to show you the user that we'll be using, it's this one. As you can see, it has full access. And for the security credentials, you can go here and check them out. Then we will need to go to the S3 service. And we are going to create a bucket specific for this application, which in this case, it's events recordings. So once again, you just go here, create a bucket, and I'll show you what this is. It's just an empty bucket. It has no objects. We will upload them later in the video. And it should be as simple as this: events recordings bucket. So AWS account, sign up for free, create a user with full access to S3 if you're just experimenting, and create a bucket. Then we go to the OutSystems Forge. We search for Amazon S3. And you'll find here the Amazon Simple Storage Service that is a supported component. Click download and install it in your environment. So that's done. Let's jump right into Service Studio. Okay, so for the application that we will be using, you can install it via the new application, start from an app, and we are going to use the Events app. And to give you a quick overview of what that looks like, let me log in with a demo user. And as you can see, we have a list of sessions for this specific event, and we can rate the session, join for a remote session, and all the details. What we will be doing is we will be changing this so we can have a way for the users to watch the recording later. So in order for our users to watch the recording, we need to put the recording somewhere in a storage place. So let's go to Service Studio, and I've built a very simple back office that lists all the sessions for the event. And then you can update the details of the session and added a section where you can upload the video. So this is the upload recording. It's the upload widget that comes with the platform, and it's binded to this local variable where it will receive the name of the file that we are uploading and the binary of the video. And then if we see what this add recording does, it just updates the video and the event session. What we want to do is stop using the database in our application and put that load into the S3 service. So to do that, we go here, and we have already referenced the component that we installed, that is the Amazon S3, and this module is the integration service one, and we'll use the object put method. So in order to do this, I'll just create a few more utilities here, which will give me the AWS credentials that I created for that user that you need to create. And this will return me the region, the access key, and the secret access key. Then we will want the bucket name. And for that, I already have that name in a function as well. And then for the key of the object, it will be the recording name that comes from the file that is being uploaded, and of course the file that is the binary data. We can use metadata, for example, to attach the video file to the session. So for example, as a quick test here, I can say that the session ID is the session title, or even more metadata that can be important for you to use. So what we are doing here, recapping, uploading a file that is only accepting video, and as soon as we add the recording, it validates if everything is okay, stores that file in the bucket that we created before with the credentials that we created before, it assigns the name, updates the session, so we have that file name to be used later, and that's it. That's how we upload a video. Later, what we want to do is in our mobile application, where we have the listing of sessions per event, we will go to the agenda detail, and as you can see, we already changed this. So we have a button that says watch recording, and that redirects to this recording screen that I've created, which checks if there's a file in S3 or not, and if it has, we show it using the video widget from OutSystems UI that needs a URL. If not, we will just show a blank state message and an option to go back to the agenda. So let's take care of this video widget that needs a URL. Three different things that you can do to retrieve an object from a bucket. You can get the binary of the data, or you can just get a pre-signed URL where you can directly access that object. And that's what we are going to use this in this video widget. So if you go here, the get recording fetching data from other resources, what we'll need is something from Amazon S3, that is the object get pre-signed URL. So as you can see here, we are getting the details of the session in particular, so we can use this as the key for the object that we want to retrieve. As you remember, let's go back here. As we were putting the object to the bucket, we were using the recording name, the name of the file. So that's the key that S3 will have when we want to retrieve that object. And so here, what we will use is what we updated in the database when we were uploading the video. So we need a few things here. And once again, we have some functions. We want to use HTTPS because we believe in it, and get the bucket name as well. With this, we just need this output parameter assigned, and it's what we are doing here, and this will be the URL. In order to finish, we just need to assign get recording URL here, and we are ready to go. And so let's take it for a spin. Let's go to Google Chrome, and I already have the application open here. Let's go to the CEO keynote, and we already have that button, watch recording, but we don't have anything here. So let's go to the back office, search for CEO, and I want to upload a video. Let's upload it to S3. Okay. Let me just check, because we never know. And this is the bucket where it's supposed to happen the magic. And here it is, the SEO keynote. And let's see what happens here. So I think the CEO keynote is here. Let's watch the recording. Yep, here it is. Awesome. And that's how you can leverage S3 and OutSystems together. Take into account that as you are handling media files, large files, the network availability is an important factor when you are implementing this use case. It's not just drag and dropping some stuff. And yes, if you were wondering, I was using the Mac Service Studio. So if you like using macOS, you can now develop natively with Service Studio for macOS. Go to the downloads page and you can install it. So I guess that's it for today's episode. Let us know in the comments what other topics you would like us to cover in this quick hits fashion. So I guess I see you in the next one. Bye bye.